my daughter, unfortunately, had to spend quite a few weeks in the Children's Hospital, both here in Chapel Hill and in Durham, because she was ill when she was almost 5 years old. And they did ultimately cure her, but it made me want to give back to the hospital. And she had a passion for swimming, and kind of marrying her experience, life experience with swimming, and came up with the idea of Swimming for Smiles. There wasn't really a good, at that time, facility for kids rather than treating adults. It wasn't a separate hospital. Since that time, they've actually built a separate standalone hospital just for kids. And to keep that going, they're going to need money for years and years and years to come. It can't just operate just off the money that comes from the government. It needs private organizations and nonprofit organizations raising money for it.
I got involved many years ago when I was a parent rep for one of the Summer Swim League teams, Heritage Hills in Chapel Hill. And the following year, I was actually the president of the board. And Gary came to many meetings, and he had some great ideas for channeling the energies of all the 1,000 swimmers that we had in the league for raising funds for kids that were less fortunate, especially kids that were sick in the local hospitals.
We came up with the idea of a nonprofit swim meet where the kids would swim for nothing but to raise money instead of for scoring or to win.
My involvement was with the precursor to Swim for Smiles, which was what was called the Swim for Life. It was a fundraiser for American Cancer Society, and we tried to get local swimmers involved, people in the university community, people in the local community, and people in the Summer Swim League community. Swimmers who love swimming and care about people. I obviously met Gary and learned about Swim for Smiles, and have been involved since then as a fundraiser, and Gary asked me to be on the board of directors.
So our first event was actually a swim meet, and soon after that we had a kids triathlon, which was pretty successful because there weren't at the time any kids triathlons in this area. The youth triathlon has sort of got a mind of its own and sort of a growth curve of its own. When we first started it 4 years ago, we had no idea that it would be as large as it is this year. I mean, this year we have 550 kids. Our first year we had about 200 kids. So in 4 years, it's grown sort of explosively.
Now what's going to happen, parents, is we're going to send these kids off every 10 seconds. That way we don't have too many kids in school at the same time.
The neat thing about it and what's unique about it is there aren't any triathlons that are USA triathlon sanctioned, the USAT sanctioned, which is the governing body of of all the people that participate in triathlons here in North Carolina that are sanctioned specifically for kids. And we thought it'd be neat to start one that's specifically for kids.
4, 3, 2, 1, 2.
These are all kids that are, for the most part, really, really fortunate, and they're very healthy. And rather than competing against each other, they're all joining forces to do something that's really good.
How are you?
My name is Evan Moran, and I'm going to be swimming in college next year. I've been swimming for like 13 years. First of all, I really love ice cream. Second of all, I hear it's for a good cause. It's definitely like a community-wide thing, so the community feels it, and I guess like it's a fun thing for kids to do.
Well, Swim for Smiles is different than a lot of other nonprofits in North Carolina, is that there's no employees. We don't pay anybody. We don't have anybody on salary. There's no payroll. Everybody's a volunteer. So we count on volunteers to actually step up and do the work that it requires to be done. And the best way to do that was to bring aboard a board that encompasses both kids and adults that have a passion for raising money, but also have a passion for the sport of swimming and triathlon. And they do all the work. So they're the volunteers that serve the food at the races. They're the volunteers that plan the races. They're the volunteers that hand out the medals at the races. And they're the volunteers that get the sponsors for the races.
The tie-in to the old Swim for Life is touching for me, having had a personal experience and been the recipient of fabulous medical care here in the community, people that cared about me personally. It is just a small way that I can touch the lives of some other people who can be helped.
I became a board member at the annual board meeting last year in 2009. I went to the meeting just to see how I could help out at all, because I know Gary Kay, who's the co-founder, and Laura Gondek, who's the other co-founder. I've swum year-round since I was about 4 or 5 years old.
Our overall winner for today's race in the long course is number 8, Alex Worden. Here's Alex here. Alex is also on the Swim for Smiles board. He does a lot of volunteering. He was here all day yesterday until 8 o'clock at night and came in this morning at 6 this morning to help set up. Thank you.
As a board member, how I mainly help out is I run the Facebook page and do a lot of publicity, you know, contact newspapers and newspaper reporters.
Most of the money really is raised by kids. They're either swimming on the relays and raising money for that, or they're organizing other little events like high throwing contests. It's children that are raising the money, and it's for other children. So it only makes sense that kids should be part of the overall representation. And being able to speak up and see how they feel and get them involved in a leadership capacity. I think that's very important.
And whatever planning aspects I'm asked to help out with, I help out with. I've learned a lot about how to try to fit an extra thing into your schedule that probably means a lot more than schoolwork, homework, just helping raise money for the North Carolina Children's Hospital.
And in third place, from Crozet, Virginia. Benton Turner.
Our goal for Swim for Smiles is to grow it to where we're ultimately raising millions of dollars for children's hospitals all around the country.
I see this as having the potential to go very big.
We've actually been actively talking to other swim clubs around the country about doing the same thing at their location. I think the greatest thing about Swim for Smiles is the experience I had in either the first or second year race, where a kid who was clearly completely as tired as he could be and just completely exhausted, crossed the finish line, immediately turned, literally threw up, looked up, smiled, and said, "Where's my medal?" That sort of summarizes what's so great about Swim for Smiles. These kids, they do everything they could do. They participate as hard as they can. They race as fast as they can. Even though they're completely exhausted, they just love what they're doing and they're passionate about it. And what's cool about it is they get to do something that they really love, but also raise money at the same time without having to go door to door to do so.
There's no shortage of kids in need, and there's no reason why we can't continue to be more helpful at every level.